Greetings. By now, it has become self-evident that you are clearly a comic book-style supervillain with campy plans for world domination, such as creating dinosaur super soldiers, hence why you are watching this video. However, one crucial thing is stopping you from fulfilling your masterful plan. Simply put, you need a remote volcanic island base or a lair to create your evil plans from. But which evil-looking volcano should you choose? Thankfully, I can help you narrow down these options as a volcanologist. All potential volcanoes and thus bases of operation will be graded on these five important categories. First, remoteness slash stealth. Is your evil volcanic base far enough away from prying eyes that it can go unnoticed, or is it perfectly hidden in plain sight? Second, intimidation. Does your volcanic base just look evil and intimidating, just giving off the vibes that the location is menacing without even a word needing to be said? Third, natural hazards. Defenses and additional evil henchmen are expensive, so why not let nature perform the same task, whether this be crocodiles, sharks that have lasers on their heads, or a lava lake to push annoying secret agents into whom are trying to foil your perfect plans? Fourth, size. Do you physically have enough space to make your evil plans and complex contraptions for world domination? And finally, fifth, resource availability, or essentially logistics. While you could have a multinational megacorporation that you solely control supply everything you need, first-time evil masterminds should instead merely use the resources easily available around them to not draw too much suspicion or attention. My first recommendation is the sinister-looking Maug Islands volcano located in the far northern reaches of the remote northern Mariana Islands. Right away, this three-island paradise gets an A grade for pure intimidation, as you can just tell that something catastrophic once occurred here, making sane people stay far away. This disaster that formed its three separate islands with incredibly steep cliffs which make them hard to access was a caldera-forming and powerful explosive eruption. We don't know when this eruption occurred, but it destroyed the vast majority of what was a 1,000-foot-tall volcanic island peak, only leaving ruins in its path. While the interior caldera might look like a void space where it is impossible to build because who knows how deep it might go, there is actually a lava dome that comes within 60 feet of the surface and its center that you can utilize as a spot to place a support beam. I suggest utilizing this structure to create a raised platform from with long narrow outdoor pathways with a rusty short railing that connects to other buildings you could create on each island. These are also shark-infested waters, which is a bonus, but with 526.3 acres or 2.13 square kilometers of highly rugged land, which even contains many trees, you have a lot to work with. Moving on, we have an active volcano which perfectly fits the description of hidden in plain sight, specifically the Akademia Nauk volcano in Russia. I suggest having a platform that rises out of this murky waters to grant access to a hidden lair underneath the lake, which then disappears once you go underground. Not only is this volcano sometimes surrounded by what is described as the world's largest highly acidic lake, but it is bordered to the northwest by one of the most active volcanoes in all of Russia, Kerensky. However, since this is not a volcanic island, you have access to all the evil resources you need in the surroundings of Russia. You could also create a similar underwater base on an island, no, the other one, beneath the lake of this Papua New Guinea volcano. The only difference is such a base will be partially protected by the crocodiles which live in its central caldera lake known as Lake Wisdom. Or, if that is not for you, how about atop a sinister-looking sea stack known as Bull's Pyramid, which rises 1,877 feet into the sky? Or, if you absolutely must have a lava lake, utilize Mount Erebus in Antarctica. Here is a quick run-through through a few other options. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Pax Andromeda, for helping to make this silly video possible by supporting my work.